Our next respected guest joins us from Denmark. Kamal Qureshi is a spokesman on the minority and human rights issues for the Danish Socialist People's Party. He has been a member of the Danish Parliament since 2001. He's also a party representative in the OSCE, Organization for Security and Cooperation in Europe. Being a popular lecturer and having contributed to various publications on the areas such as multiculturalism and equal rights, I would like to welcome him to our Jalsa Salana and would request him to come and say a few words.
Thank you for this invitation. I feel privileged to be able to address the MD community on the behalf of my party and as a member of the Danish Parliament. I had a walk yesterday through East London. Just on this rather short walk, I saw two beautiful mosques built for the purpose of prayer and reflection. I couldn't help myself thinking that in Copenhagen, where I'm from, we still have to celebrate our Eid and other holidays in sports arenas, old workshops, and small apartments. In Copenhagen, we still don't have a mosque built for the purpose of prayer and reflection. And even today, influential Danish political leaders regard all mosques as a breeding ground for terrorism. Even though the government in Denmark speaks of religious freedom and diversity, we still have a long way before there is a mosque where Muslims can pray and a graveyard where Muslims can be buried according to their beliefs and not in a corner of a Christian graveyard. The tragedy in Oslo has put us all in deep sorrow, especially us from the Scandinavian countries who share strong links with the Norwegian friends. Unfortunately, the debate was immediately to point out the culprits as Muslims. The fact shows that it was an attack from a Christian right-wing person. That just shows that religion is not the base for terror attack. People are the base of terror attack. The respect for religious diversity is unfortunately not only lacking in Danish politics. When I was a medical student in Copenhagen, there was a wish to establish a union for students with Pakistani heritage. It was a good idea and I supported it. But already at the first meeting, it was demanded from few dominant persons that MD students should not be allowed membership of this union. I had a hard time understanding this argument, and it was an attempt to build a Pakistani association, and I feel it's a contradiction when a minority group starts their meeting by excluding another minority. Unfortunately, we did not bridge our disagreement, and I ended up building another union with a more inclusive agenda. You can say that our agenda was very much as your love for all, hatred for none. Religion brings out the best in people, but unfortunately also the worst in some people. There are people that are persecuted because of their beliefs as we speak. Some people see their search for religious truth as hatred against others. Every year, we see attacks against MDs around the world. Just last year, we saw several attacks in Pakistan. The more Pakistan is sinking into poverty and despair, the more is religious extremism growing. I have every time taken steps to protest against the lack of adequate response from the Pakistani government against persecution of religious minorities in Pakistan. Religious acceptance and tolerance doesn't come by itself, unfortunately, neither locally in our communities nor at the national or global level. On the contrary, it is something we need to fight for in our day-to-day lives. When somebody tries to exclude others from participation because of their religious beliefs, we need to speak up. Whether this takes place in our children's kindergarten, at our universities, our workplaces, or at the local market. But we also need to commit our political and religious leaders to act against persecution, whether it is at community level, national level, or global level. Only thereby can we create a world with respect for religious diversity and tolerance, a world with love for all and hatred for none. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Now.